The latest, obviously, is of moving Honorable Sylvia Mansell from the Ministry of Health to the Ministry of Lands and Natural Resources, and Honorable Elijah Mchima has been tasked with the Ministry of Health. There are others that want President Hichilema might be firing ailing ministers rather than retransferring the ministers or rearranging his cabinet within that respect. I'd love to get your submission just before you can open the phone lines in that line.
I would want to tell you, Thomas, that Mr. Hichilema is a very weak leader. Extremely weak leader. And he's weak because he's very compromised. If he were not compromised, he would not be acting the way he's acting. That is why, as a president, you must be careful how far you go with your dealing and how far you go with your familiarity. Mr. Hichilema has failed the people of Zambia, because how do you explain you remove an engineer? Honorable Kapala is an engineer. You remove him at the time when Zambia is having all these issues. And you bring Makoto Chikota, my friend, I was with him in Parliament. You bring him, because I was in the Foreign Service. His understanding of energy issues and that kind of stuff is not there. So basically, Mr. Kainde Hichilema wants to have it.
Watch the entire video, my lovely viewers, I mean from start to finish, to get the whole thing. Without wasting much of your time, let's get right into it. Hi lovely viewers, it's me again, your one and only Mtati Mpundu. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time on my channel, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel by hitting the red subscribe button down below and turn the bell icon to join the notification squad. Don't forget to like, share and leave a comment. Tell me what you think about this video in the comment section below. I'll be super glad to hear from you lovely viewers.
Before we move on, President Kalaba, with regards to the declaration of President Hichilema's assets, we were told that 2021, the President declared the assets and record are seated at the Electoral Commission of Zambia. This has been the argument too. Yet. No, when you say that he has not declared his assets, what are you pointing to?
Now, let me tell you one thing. What happens is that before you go in government, you said if you are aspiring for a constitutional office like the President's, you, and I did declare myself as well.
Sure.
My assets. Then once you declare your assets, again, because now you have assumed public office, you are required to formally now declare your assets.
Even if there is no law that compels one to do so?
No, there is a law.
Which law is that?
There's a provision that requires constitutional office holders, members of parliament, ministers, vice president, and the president. They are required by law.
Which law is that?
The Zambians have said we want to know how much you are worth. If you are a serious person with corruption, to allay fears, you will declare your assets.
Okay.
The president didn't. He has not. So you cannot fight corruption on one hand. When you yourself, who should be fighting corruption vigorously, you've decided to hide your property. So that when you'll be asked later, you'll say, this is how much I'm worth. That is not correct. That is telling you that there is something that is not right with our president. Then there is the issue of Dr. Brian Kab. He gives you serious revelations happening at the Anti-Corruption Commission. What does the president do? Instead of saying, I congratulate you, let's do this. The president conveniently calls Tom Shamakan. It is the Director General, and he tells him that, can you please resign? He is forced to resign, and when Tom Shabakamba is forced to resign, the President goes ahead and doesn't give the same privilege to the board to call them the way he called Tom Shabakamba to resign. Because he would have told the board, colleagues, I've got misgivings with you, I think just resign. But all he wanted was to embarrass eminent personalities that like people like Musa Moyi, who have worked hard for their integrity. He has saved, I've saved with him when he was our Attorney General, when President Sata was leading this country. I was with him in cabinet. We know people by how they conduct their affairs. And now he just serves in your government for 2 years. You want to look at him and frown upon him and say, this board was not doing his job, they were not fighting corruption. The fact that you can dissolve the ACC board, when they have raised pertinent issues on what is going on in the country, The fact that the FIC report has exposed you and you have failed to deal with the millions of dollars that have been cited in the FIC report, you decide to gloss over it and dissolve the board which should be working with the Financial Intelligence Center. It is a problem. So in this country, the fight against corruption has been lost. In this country, the fight against corruption is targeted at individuals. In this country, the fight against corruption is who is who. How can we deal with our political opponents? You know, take example of the former president, President Lungu, the one we are talking about. President Lungu was detained or put under house arrest from the time that he handed over power to Mr. Hakainde Hichilema. Just by him having given him power freely and without any restrictions, gave him power, President Hakainde Hichilema made sure that President Lungu does not travel outside the country. President Hakainde Hichilema made sure that President Lungu stopped jogging. President Hakainde Hichilema made sure that the relatives of the former president were all in trouble. He made sure that he doesn't go for his medical reviews and things like that. That is how he has treated his brother. And by the way, that's a very important thing, because that is something, that's a culture which must come to an end. Using the Anti-Corruption Commission to fix political enemies. You must allow the Anti-Corruption Commission. I think it was in, there was a central instrument that was issued. A government gazette notice. I think it's gazette notice number 11, is it 1123? Yes, I think it's 1123, which was issued on the 23rd of October 2021. That gazette notice was basically taking the Anti-Corruption Commission under President Chilema's desk, the Drug Enforcement Commission, the Financial Intelligence Center, all those institutions were put under his desk. Now, if the Anti-Corruption Commission, you have dissolved it and they're under your purview, it means you're saying you yourself, you're very incompetent. Because those are institutions, rightly so, under your office. Institutions of government that were supposed to have been watchdog institutions. But you've taken them under your office so that you can choose who to persecute. You can choose who to fix. You can choose, and when they don't fix people you want to fix, because they want things to be done in an appropriate way, you dissolve them. That's what happened to the Musa Mwenye SEC board. They were dissolved simply because they could not do what the appointing authority was doing. In his head, that president of ours, he was sure that once I give you a position, you are supposed to do as I want. But then he found men and women of integrity who stood up to his Lingala.
The UPND administration is expressing dissatisfaction with regards to the statements that has been coming forth from you as opposition political players. And I should put it on record that in the words of Cornelius Mwetwa, he says that we do not have a serious opposition in this very country with regards to corruption. With regards to corruption, the National Prosecution Authority reveals that over 3 billion right now has been recovered from the proceeds of crime, as far as money that was parked in people's houses. And of course, we've seen quite a number of individuals that have appeared before the investigative wings in line with them explaining how they acquired certain properties. In that line, we've seen in this administration, permanent secretaries have been fired because of the alleged involvement in line with corruption. We saw a minister, and I should, of course, this is in public domain, Rapula Province Minister, been fired because of the alleged involvement in issues of corruption. When you begin to criticize specifically with regards to what you're not seeing as seriously as far as this fight is concerned, are you doing it out of politics, or really and truly there's nothing that you've seen ever since President Hichilema took office, the zeal to fight corruption with what he's been saying, fighting previous, past, the present, as well as future corruption with his zero tolerance approach to corruption?
Look, I have told you here, and I have told you with empirical evidence, that our president is not fighting corruption in the manner corruption has to be fought. Wale Sala is choosing who to prosecute, is choosing who to persecute, even as he said it himself in Parliament. He said, we will prosecute and persecute. So he is choosing who to prosecute and persecute. If he sees, oh, Harry Kalab has got that, they are going to send people on Harry Kalab. If he says, you are my enemy in politics, he's going to send. Look at the double standards, the way he's doing things. Let's look at the double standards. Whatever we are talking about here, it is all diluted. Because had he left the Anti-Corruption Commission, Mena Musa Mwenye, you should bring Mr. Musa Mwenye here. Let him come and talk why his board was dissolved for you. So get it so that you can hear that if there is anybody in the country who does not fight corruption, it is the UPA assuming power. I told you, Mr. President, what you need to do with the fight against corruption is allow the Anti-Corruption Commission to be independent. Because the law is blind. Don't show them that go for that one, go for that one, go for that one. They'll end up making mistakes. That's why they can go and harass people. But they're not making a lot of success in terms of prosecutions. You know? Why? Because there is limited time for them to understand the depth of the failure that has been committed. The SEC was supposed to have been left alone to deal with issues that they are best trained for. But the president hijacked that role. And now look how the fight against corruption has turned out. The fight against corruption now is a circus. We have lost it. And no amount of cheap talk is going to convince me and those in the citizens first that Mr. Akahinde Hichilema is fighting corruption. He doesn't fight corruption. What he does is to fight political opponents. And you do these things of for features. You get something from somebody, even before the person goes ahead to the court to appeal, even before they appeal, you go and you're on TV and you announce to say, oh, we have managed to do this. Again, you play politics every time. Let the process be exhausted. Give people chance. When people are given chance, even when you have they have forfeited their property, it will be after thorough investigations have been done and the court processes will have been followed. Not the way we are doing it. Because I don't like GBM, therefore GBM, I'm coming for you. Because I don't like machine time, I'm coming for you. Because I don't like, it should not be like that. The law must be blind. If people have committed crimes in the past, if people have committed crimes in the present, the Anti-Corruption Commission must be able to move at breakneck speed. What I will do myself as president is only to give them the political will. Enough finances, enough personnel. Mm-hmm. Do your job. Don't even ask me when you are arresting a minister. Well, that's not my job. Let's go ahead and do it. Because if they are wrong, they are wrong. And then we move on.
Just on one component of the article that was issued by State Counsel Musa Mwenye, in line with his time at the Anti-Corruption Commission. He said, and I quote, I strongly believe that we cannot fight corruption unless we fight all corruption, past, present and future. Those who committed corruption in the past regimes must be investigated and prosecuted. Even current government officials who have betrayed the trust of the Zambian people must also be investigated and prosecuted. Almost 3 years down the line, we should have seen some government officials arrested and dismissed. This is a matter that was a constant source of friction between the board and those who refused to do their job in this regard. Instead, they elected to be selective in the discharge of their duties and responsibilities. This is, according to him, manipulation that was happening at the Anti-Corruption Commission. The board was dissolved, and of course we expect the president to surely appoint a new board. With this said, and of course commendation to Dr. Brian Kaba, as well as State Council, regards to revealing this, do you think there is genuineness attached to fighting corruption, especially under the current administration?
No, Thomas, I've said it. I mean, there's no genuineness in the fight against corruption. If it was Harry Kalaba who was saying, an outsider at the Anti-Corruption Commission, mm-hmm. then you would say Kalaba just playing politics. The one who is speaking is Musa Mwenye. Musa Mwenye, ewa ni board chairman of Anti-Corruption Commission. Ewa lelanda. at the fight against corruption is artificial. It is Musa Mwenye saying that. It is O'Brien Kava, Dr. O'Brien Kava, who is saying that kunakuwa corruption commission to ayikala. Alabu fale beba. There is no fighting corruption. Vale sala mle sala 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 chinkamba eli kuno. Tule sala kio tulefu ta prosecutor tule sala. It's Dr. O'Brien Kava saying that. It's not ayikala. So, abali munshi ya mubundu. Hebu mfoko shirelu kuta. It is those who are inside that house who can tell us whether corruption is being fought. And they are telling you that corruption is not being fought. That the president has been hypocritical when it comes to the fight against corruption. The president is shielding nephews and whoever is shielding in the fight against corruption. There are some people he doesn't want to be prosecuted simply because he loves them dearly and he wants to do things at the expense of the nation. Now, I say, when you are president, kuli Musa Mwenye. But President Navasevana, Kumulandoa statement Dr. O'Brien Kava has issued. It's not even Harikala about saying that. It's in public domain. There is no fight against corruption in this country. What is there is fight against political opponents and persecution. Period.
How do we restore confidence in especially the investigative wings? Because they have been accused left, right, and center of being selective. Because now we'll be looking forward to which team the president will assemble as the board for the SEC. From your recommendations as the president of the Citizens Face, what are you looking forward to, especially with regards to how best confidence can be instilled in these investigative wings?
Well, I don't know what type of people the president will appoint. Mm-hmm. And I remain in a very confused state. Mm-hmm. To understand what type of people will the president appoint to head the anti-corruption commission. If honorable patriots that this country has produced in the lives of Musa Mwenye, Professor Dr. O'Brien Kava, can be discarded, if you cannot celebrate the likes of those two, that's mentioned as an example, who else are you going to bring that will fight, that will do the fight against corruption to the expectations of our people? Because ever since Musa Mwenye was appointed, nobody complained about him or his persona. Why is it that he has been checked and reasons have not been given for dissolving the board? Simply because they raised issues against the president's favorite. They have told you that the board had difficulties meeting the president for over 3 years that he has been president. They had challenges meeting, and yet the DG was meeting the president on a daily basis. The board was prevented from dealing with cases directly or knowing who is being investigated. Tom Shamakamba was told to go straight to State House to tell the president. And then the president, typical of his leadership, he would want to say, okay, this one, I leave him. This one, Mkonke, you see today's headline. This one, that's what President Lamin and Mr. Chilema does things. Now, it is that kind of low manner of dealing with government issues that has cast aspersions on the fight against corruption. And it is sad that the fight against corruption has been lost by a person who was telling us, once I come in, we'll make sure that it is zero tolerance to corruption. And yet we see corruption in all fields, in the medical field, in the procurement of goods and services. It's all corruption, scandal after scandal. And the president doesn't even mind about that. In the procurement of fuel, people have raised issues. The president doesn't care about that. Because for him, for as long as it is benefiting him and whoever he's supporting, that's not corruption. It's only corruption when you don't do what he tells you to do, which is contrary to government regulations. Then you say you are on your own. Zambia is in trouble.
Before I open the phone lines real quick, I would love to get your reaction to the recent reshuffles that the president has carried within his cabinet. Of course, it started with moving Honorable Makozo Chikoje from the Ministry of Fisheries to Ministry of Energy and moving Honorable Peter Kapala from the Ministry of Energy to the Ministry of Fisheries as well as Livestock. The latest, obviously, is of moving Honorable Sylvia Mansell from the Ministry of Health to the Ministry of Lands and Natural Resources. And Honorable Elijah Mchima has been tasked with the Ministry of Health. There are others that want President Hichilema to be firing ill ministers rather than retransferring the ministers or rearranging his cabinet within that respect. I'd love to get your submission just before we can open the phone lines. Is that right?
I would want to tell you, Thomas, that Mr. Hichilema is a very weak leader. Extremely weak leader. And he's weak because he's very compromised. If he were not compromised, he would not be acting the way he's acting. That is why, as a president, you must be careful how far you go with your dealings and how far you go with your familiarity. Mr. Hichilema has failed the people of Zambia, because how do you explain you remove an engineer? Honorable Kapala is an engineer. You remove him at the time when Zambia is having all these issues. And you bring Makothe Chikota, my friend, I was with him in Parliament. You bring him, because I was in the Foreign Service. His understanding of energy issues and that kind of stuff is not there. So basically, Mr. Kaende Hichilema wants to have a direct oversight.
Isn't the argument that PSCs are the ones that do a lot of work in these ministries?
No. Mm. Ministers have got policy oversight. When you are saying that Zambia is going to, even the load shedding management, it's approved by cabinet. They decide that we are going to export such and such tariffs to this country. It is cabinet which decides. They decide that we are going to have cost reflective tariffs. And then they fire that ERB guy, they fire him. And yet it's a decision made by cabinet. You fire this person because you have increased the price of petroleum, you have increased the price of electricity. And then you don't reverse what he did, but you have fired him. It's those small politics that are sometimes irritating. And I think it's high time that the president began getting serious with his ministers. Transferring a problem from one ministry to another is not the solution. You need to deal with the issue at Ministry of Health. What was the problem with Madam Maseru at Health? Are you confirming the rumors that are going around? Because what he has just done is that he has put Madam Maseru in a very awkward position. That's what he has done. I don't know, maybe for some reason he wants to finish her politically or what. Because just what he has done, he's telling the public, your suspicions or your murmuring out there is true. That's why I'm moving her from health. I'm taking her to lands. You know? He's telling the public that all these tender issues happening in Ministry of Health, all the wrong things which were happening in Ministry of Energy, Honorable Peter Kapala had something to do with them. So I have moved him. That is not the way to finish your friends. That is not the way to weaken your friends who have fought for you, who have been with you when it mattered most. It's wrong, Mr. President. Avoid using people in that manner. This is DJ Mutati
exclusive. Alright, that's all for you today, lovely viewers. If you did enjoy the video, please don't forget to leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me what you think about the video you just watched in the comment section below. I'll be super glad to hear from you, lovely viewers. Once again, I go by the name of Mutati Mpundu. I love you, peace. I gotta go.